Mobile area escaping the wrath of deadly tornadoes, but other parts of Alabama, Mississippi, and Louisiana did not.
Yeah, at least four people are dead, including two in Alabama, when an estimated two dozen tornadoes just blasted through the southeast yesterday.
Steve Alexander with a look at some of the worst damage.
Imagine looking outside from work and seeing something like this.
Man, it's over to school.
Yeah, that's not good.
Is it coming back this way?
I don't know.
That was what happened to people near Columbia, Mississippi yesterday, just west of Hattiesburg. These people looked out of their home in Guntown in northeast Mississippi, heard the strong wind blowing, and saw debris flying around. The National Weather Service confirms 18 twisters tore through Mississippi yesterday. One woman in Mississippi talked about hearing the tornado warning while she was driving.
When the warning went off through my speakers, it was there. I was in the middle of it. And I was probably about a tenth of a mile north of Colt Lane. I couldn't control the steering. I tried to slow down. A lot of debris. Everything was gray.
In Alabama, two people were killed and four or five injured in Town Creek in the northwest part of the state. The two that died were a husband and a wife.
County Road 265 was blocked with tree and debris, so it was just total chaos, and we just had to make do the best we could.
A seven-year-old boy was found injured near the couple and taken to a hospital. But despite the tragedy, public service workers know the damage and death toll could have been worse.
We're thankful. We're blessed that, you know, in public safety realm, you know, when disaster strikes, no matter what the differences are, we all come together and we work together as one.
Steve Alexander, Fox 10 News.
And Governor Kay Ivey issuing a statement today on the deadly twister that roared through the Town Creek community. She said in part, and we quote, "I join the community of Town Creek in grieving the loss of a husband and wife. While most of us slept through the storm, a family waking up today devastated."